apologises. I've made two previous videos on this, and this is the third one. The last video, part two, was I think about 3 years ago, so I think a third part is well overdue. This is my journal. I write things down in it, things that inspire me, songs, books, movies, poems, and I just keep them all in one spot. So if you haven't already, go and watch part one, part two, and then come back here and you can watch this part for an updated version on the book. So, I have actually filled in quite a lot of the book. If you look here, over half the book is completed, but there's still a load of blank pages. I don't draw in it nearly as much as I used to, but I do now and then. I think I most recently drew in it maybe a month or so ago. I nearly showed you my real name then, it's on the front page. Okay, I want to show you a couple of updated pages. Oops, before I get started with the new ones. I'm going to do this as quick as I can though, because my throat's being a bit funny. I can feel a coughing fit coming on. I spoke too soon. All I have to drink is some cold. To the final four books and the final five films. I rated It's not in the film, but in the film, sorry, in the book, Lily, Harry finds a letter which Lily wrote to Sirius Black before she died, and the bottom of the letter is ripped off, and for the majority of the book, he doesn't find it. And then during the Princess Tale portion, we see that it was Snape who ripped the bottom of the letter off and kept it because it had lots of love Lily written on it, and obviously, intention of living in an apartment anymore, but the rest of them I'm still confident I'll be able to do. So this one, yep, I did that in 2016. Travel abroad alone, I did that in 2017 when I went to New York. Knit something under the dress square, I cheated on this one. I don't like knitting, but I did learn how to crochet, and I've crocheted lots of things. I've crocheted hats and scarves and cushions and blankets and little toys. So I've crossed that one off. Go for a hike on my own. I've done that several times. of a skyscraper. I went to Top of the Rock and the Empire State Building, so that's done. Visit a Christmas market. When I went to Amsterdam at the end of 2016, I went with my sister and we went about a week, less than a week before Christmas. We spent 3 days there and we went to a Christmas market. So that was very, very nice. Come out of my shell. I feel a lot more confident than I did, 5-10 years ago. And I've had people tell me that, so ticked it off. And lastly, I have not seen the sunrise and set in a single day. However, I have seen the sunrise. I got up very, very early, a couple of months ago. I drove out to the Peak District. I climbed a hill, a small hill, but a hill, and I saw the sunrise, and it was very, very nice. So that is my 30 before 30 list. Now I'm going to talk through the rest of my pages. I don't think this will be as long as, you know, my last videos, but there's still quite some things in here. Now, this is from a TV show I used to love when I was younger. It's called The Worst Witch. And I recently found some episodes on Dailymotion. And I rewatched them and it was really nice watching them again. And this is the theme song from that. This is from a dream I had a few years ago. Now, I am a bit weird. I've never had a nightmare. Wow, the rain is really coming down now. I have never had a nightmare. And if I do have a nightmare, I don't find it very scary because I like being scared. I like feeling uneasy. So I'm a bit weird like that. And this is the weirdest film I've had for a while. And it just stuck with me in my dream. I'm walking down a wide, deserted road, and there are yellow lampposts, like yellow light, coming from lampposts either side of me. And I'm walking down the middle of the road, and as I'm walking, there's this man stood at the top of the lamppost, and he's just watching me walk down this road. And then when I walk past his lamppost, he flies to the next one and watches me again. And that is literally all my dream. That happened, but it was the way he looked at me with, I thought was weird. And I remember he had big black wings instead of arms. I couldn't see his face. I couldn't see much of him. I just knew he was in black and he had big wings and he flew from lamppost to lamppost just staring at me as I walked down the street. So if anyone knows who he is or if that's, like, you know, if it means something, do let me know. I called him Raven Man. And when I had this dream, I wrote down what I saw and what I thought at the time. This is a rhyme from the film Holes with Shia LaBeouf. So, yeah. And then this is from a scene from Empire Strikes Back. Now in the film, there's a bit of a back and forth between Leia and Han Solo, and then Han kisses Leia, and then C-3PO walks in and interrupts them and they break apart. On YouTube, however, there's a deleted or extended scene, and there's a bit more dialogue between them, and in the deleted scene, Han kisses Leia, they break apart, and then Leia says to Han, "Okay, I'll shut." And then she kisses him. And then C-3PO walks in and interrupts them. Because if you watch very carefully in the film, they kiss. And then when C-3PO interrupts them, literally a second later, she's got her arm around him. But that doesn't make sense. It's because there's a deleted bit. So please go and watch that. Because it is a really, really sweet moment. And I love it. Also, I can't draw people very well, so the faces are a bit rubbish. Random bits from random films. This is from The Joker. Introduce a little anarchy, upset the established order, and everything becomes chaos. Imagine a Storm. Don't know where that's from. This is from Frasier. Caught Me With Me Hand in the Biscuit Tin. This is from Africa by Toto, one of my favourite songs. Guess where that's from? Dr. Grant, My Dear Dr. Settler, welcome to Jurassic Park. And lastly, this. Expecto Patronum. This is J.K. Rowling's handwriting. Someone asked her on Twitter if she could write down Expecto Patronum because this guy said he wanted a tattoo of her handwriting on him. And I copied it and put it in my book, so that is J.K. Rowling's handwriting. Pretty neat. Okay, this is from a TV show. One of my, in fact, my all-time favourite TV show. Mr. Vernon, we accept the fact that we had to sacrifice a whole Saturday in detention for whatever it was we did wrong. What we did was wrong, but we think you're crazy to make us write an essay telling you who we think we are. You see us as you want to see us, in the simplest terms, the most convenient definitions. But what we found out is that each of us is a brain, and an athlete, and a basket case, a princess. Sincerely yours, The Breakfast Club. Fantastic film. On Netflix and Amazon Prime in the UK. Watch it. Random thoughts. I'll not explain that. Another quote. Obviously this quote is not from Wild by Reese Witherspoon, but it's in the film. If your nerve deny you, go above your nerve. Emily Dickinson. Harry Potter. Must have been watching Harry Potter when I read that. And then this is William Wallace's speech from Braveheart. I fight and you'll die. Run and you'll live. At least a while. And dying in your beds many years from now. Would you be willing to drink? apologize from this day to that for one chance, just one chance, to come back here and tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom. Alba Cupra. Fantastic. And that is my dire attempt at a Scott accent. Up the Scots. This is unfinished, but I will finish it as soon as possible. This has been a work in progress for a long while now. I'm quite proud of this. I'm quite proud of Darth Vader, but I couldn't get Luke right, so Luke looks a bit weird. This is a bit bittersweet. I drew this, I think a couple of weeks before Carrie Fisher died. It took me ages to get her face right, and it's not even right, it doesn't look like her, but I don't care. So that is very, very bittersweet. I drew that in my invisible ink pen, just in tribute, because Kenny Baker and Carrie Fisher are both dead now. So that is my tribute to them both. Bless them. So I will finish this. If you have any ideas of what I can draw on this page, please give me some ideas. I think I tried drawing the Millennium Falcon on a practice bit of paper and it was really hard, so just let me know. Really good film. It's called A Monster Calls. I think it's on Amazon Prime. And this is voiced by Liam Neeson. It's about a monster who visits a kid. And I just really like the film. Stars are wild creatures. When you let them loose, who knows what havoc they may wreak. Your mind will believe comforting lies while also knowing the painful truths that make those lies necessary. Because humans are complicated beasts. Really good. This one is a poem and it's from the film 13. I don't know if you've seen it. It's got Evan Rachel Wood and Holly Hunter in it. And it's a really good film. It's a bit unnerving, but it's very, 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 very good film. He was crippled, but only his body was cracked. It's not simple, nor is it an easy manner to explain. Let's just leave it at that, she says, and closes the holy book of lies. She covers her eyes, denying to herself what she thought happened. Good film, 13. I said I've not done that much since I last. I don't really draw in it that very often, but I do draw in it, just not very often. This is the last page. If you recognise this, then congratulations, you have good taste. This is from Stranger Things on Netflix, and a few pages ago I drew 11. Is also from Stranger Things. This is from season 2. Now, I am ashamed of myself. I watched season 1, loved it, and when season 2 came out, I didn't watch it for about 6 months. No, more than that. Yeah, it was absolutely ages, probably more like 10 months. It took me 10 months to watch it because I just didn't want. I just loved the first series so much, I didn't want to ruin it by watching the second series, and you know what? I think the second series was probably as good as the first. I absolutely loved it. And in the second series, this weird spider creature is in it. Now, this is not finished, I'm going to add some more stuff down here. But I drew that very recently, I drew that about a month or so ago. They're just some random films that I wrote down. Really random. You'll have to pause and watch the list, but yeah. Anyway, so that is the last official page in my book. you can see, I've got quite a lot crossed off actually. Visit a country outside of Europe. I did that when I went to India. And also the USA. See a wild exotic animal. I did that. I saw elephants and monkeys in India. I don't know if people would call them exotic, but I think elephants and monkeys are exotic. Get my degree and a job, which I definitely did. Paint a picture. I did that. I don't have it to hand right now, otherwise I'd show you. It's only small. It's probably about the same size as this book, but I painted it. Go for a hike or walk by myself. That one says I did that. In case you're interested, I have not done either of these two under this. This is another one I don't want you to see, but I have done that. I just don't want to tell you what I've done. Volunteer, yeah, I've done that. A station, I've done that. London, done that. Drive tram, done that. Have I done anything else? I have actually climbed a mountain before. I've climbed Mount Snowdon, but I've not climbed Mount Snowdon since I was a kid, and I want to do it again, so I'm leaving that blank until I do that again. Become a teacher, boom, done that. Seen opera or a play, I did that. I went to London, I saw Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, which is a play. It is fantastic. It's a bit weird though, it's like, it feels like fan fiction. But it's still really entertaining. I think of it not as a part of the Harry Potter films. I just see it as a bit of a standalone thing. But I do love it nonetheless. I've seen it twice now. So, brilliant. Go blonde. I'm naturally brunette. I did that last year. I had my hair not completely blonde, but more like a, what's the word? I had most of it dyed blonde and then I left my roots natural. Not an ombre, it was like further up my head than an ombre, like a shadow root. So I went blonde. Spend a day in the cinema, yes, I've done that a few times now. I've seen, I think, 3 films in one day is my record. Run a 5k, I'm determined to do that one day, but it has not yet happened since. And that is it. The only other new thing in my book is in here. Where I keep all my knickknacks. I've added one more thing. It is my Paris Metro ticket that I used last month. Anyway, that is my complete up-to-date journal. And you know something? This is about the 8th take I've done of this video now, so I'm so glad I finally got it done. The first few times, my phone was running out of battery. Then I had a coughing fit. Then someone interrupted me, and then I accidentally showed you my name on the front page. So I'm finally glad that's done. It might be another 3 years before you see this thing again, but I hope you enjoyed that. If you have any requests for videos, you can